current in the mid downstream fault current. In order to clear the aim of the project, let's have a very short review on power quality issues. Today, power quality is a service and many customers are paying for it, but relatively in a simple way, in particular for continuity of the service. In the near future, most of DSOs could decide or could be obliged by the authorities to supply their customers with different power quality levels at different prices. The most considerable and frequent problem in the field of power quality is voltage dip. Voltage dip is a short duration reduction in RMS value of the voltage in the range of 10% to 90%, which is the main results of short circuit, overload voltage, or even inrush current of big motors. In the graph, you can see distribution of voltage dips in terms of duration and magnitude in the power quality survey in 2014 in city of Brescia. As you see, most of voltage dips are in the range of 20% reduction in magnitude and for a very short time, around 10 cycles. More or less the same trend is observed in other power quality surveys. As you see in a simple distribution network, if a fault occurs on one of the feeders, the voltage at the point of common coupling can be calculated using the voltage division rule. As a result of fault, a reduction in magnitude and a phase jump can be expected, as you see in the phase of representation. Compensating this voltage dip is demanded from several points of view. The main approach in order to mitigate voltage dip is employing a custom power system device. This device could be an interruptible power supply, a solid state transfer switch, or a dynamic voltage restorer, or in short form, a DVR. DVR, which is the case of our discussion. DVR is a series connected device that's used in